I have some data I'd like to process. I have three runs taken under a baseline condition for my product. I modified the product and took another three runs of data. In one of these runs of data are time histories consisting of some microphone data and some RPM data. I'm going to take the baseline, put it in the input basket. I'm also going to take the modified data, add it to the input basket, go here to time data selection, take the data from the input basket, and if I look here, I can see I got three baseline runs and three modified runs available for processing. Going over to time data processing, I think at first I'm going to try and decide how I want to process the data, so I'm selecting just one of the runs, and I'm coming over here, and I have a choice under measurement mode, major decision to make how I want to process this. I can do it tracked, where I see the sound FFTs evolve as a function of time or RPM, or I can do stationary where I get a single average. I'll try stationary first. It's all set up to process. It's going to store it under the name TP here, which stands for throughput processing. Here is my processed data results. Taking a look at that, and I got a nice single average spectrum. Well, I think I'd rather have a waterfall instead. So I'm going to go back to time data processing, and I'm going to change my tracking mode or measurement mode to tracked here, where it goes from 1500 RPM to 3000 RPM in steps of 25. Still will have the same extension. I'll hit calculate, and then I'll go and view the result and see if it's looking like I'd like to analyze the data. Drop it in the display here, and it looks pretty good. That's how I like to analyze my my data. So I'm going to go back to time data processing, select all the channels from all the runs. I'm going to process it the same way. I can come back here to baseline, and I'm going to delete what I've done so far, because now I want to process everything. So I have those three runs of baseline, three runs of modified. I'll even reset this back to one, and then I'll hit calculate. Now it's doing 2 of 6, 3 of 6, 4 of 6, 5 of 6, 6 of 6. I go to look at my runs. Oh, well, they all have this name, TP1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's hard to tell what's going on. So I'm going to use one of the options here in throughput processing to help me. I'm going to go under this triple dot button, and I'm going to say run name PostScript. I deleted the previous runs. I'm going to hit calculate after I reset this to one again. Now I'm processing in batch all the runs, and we'll take a look. Well, now I have run 1 TP1, run 1 TP2. I have some idea which run the data is from, but it's still not obvious if it's from baseline or from modified. So let's try this processing one more time. So I'll delete these runs that I just processed, and I'll go back here, and I'm going to switch this to, say, original section. Baseline and modified are sections in my project called processing. I'm actually in the section called baseline. I can switch between sections here, baseline and modified. They're two different sections of my project. I said process to original section, and then when I look here, now I've run one, and I have my processed results for run one, run two, my processed results for run two, run three, and it's clearly defined whether it's from the baseline section or from the original section. I go into one of these, can take a look at the data, drop it in a display if I'd like, zoom in, change the format to DB, etc.